Hello everyone, welcome to the chapter 9 tracking part 2. In this session we are going to learn about the corner pin 2D and the planar tracker. First we will go with the corner pin 2D. Corner pin 2D is designed to map the four corners of an image sequence to or from positions delivered from the tracking data. 2 means the last tracking point. From means the first tracking point. So, in simple words, you can say, in order to calculate the value in four corner future and to insert a new image into it, we need corner pin 2D. Now, let's open the Nuke and see how corner pin 2D works. First, I'll change the interface to third style by pressing Shift plus F3 because I'm more comfortable in working with this style. Now, let's import the footage first. Now, press the numerical 1 in the keyboard to view the footage. Now see here, we have a digitally painted TV over here. We'll track this TV and insert a footage into this TV screen by placing the four tracker points on the four corners of this TV. So for that, we need to take tracker node. About this tracker node, I have explained you in chapter 4 detailedly. If you have any doubts, you can check that video. Now, press the Tab key in the keyboard and type tracker and select from the drop-down menu list. Connect this arrow to this footage and viewer node to this tracker node. And in the property panel, scroll down little bit and click on this Add Tracker button. Now see here, a new tracker has added in the property panel, and here in the viewer panel also, you can see the tracker. Now I am placing this tracker over here at this corner of the TV. Now again go to this property panel and click on this Add Tracker button again to add the second tracker. And now I am placing this tracker at this corner of the TV. In the same way, add the third and the fourth tracking points at the bottom of the TV corners. Yes, it's done. Now it's time to track the four tracking points. You can track them individually or you can select them all and track at a time. So I have selected all the four trackers and I'm clicking on this forward tracker button. Yes, it's done. Tracking is finished. Now let's import the footage to insert into the screen. Now go to the tracker node property panel. Over here in the export section, we have a multiple options, which we have already seen in the match move in chapter 4. Now we'll go with the corner pin 2D current frame and click on create button. Now see here, corner pin 2D has been generated. This green line indicates that corner pin 2D is being linked to tracker node. That means corner pin 2D follows all the attributes of the tracker node. Here in the property panel, if you want to increase the motion blur, you can increase here. And rest of all options, we don't require mostly. Now attach this corner pin 2D arrow to this image. Now let's take the merge node by pressing the letter M in the keyboard and attach this arrow A to this corner pin 2D node. And arrow B to this TV footage. And viewer node to this merge node. Now see here, in the viewer panel, the image is larger than the TV footage. We need to scale it down to fit into the TV screen. So let's take the transformation node by pressing the letter T in the keyboard. Now let's scale it down and place it inside the TV screen. If you have any doubts on the transformation node, please check the video of chapter 2 and now, adjust the scaling of this image of the length individually to fit perfectly on the inside borders of the TV screen. And slightly adjust the position of the x-axis value also. Now, it's look good. So, let's play the video once and check it. Yes, the image has been inserted into the TV screen. Now, we will import another footage of the green screen. Take the transformation node and connect this viewer node to this transformation node. Now take the key light node to eliminate the green screen. Press the Tab key and type the key light and select from the drop down list. About this key light node, I have given an in-depth explanation in chapter 5, so please check the video once if you have any doubts. Now over here in the property panel, click on this color picker button. Now hold the control and drag the mouse on the green screen. Now go to the alpha mode by pressing the letter A. Now see here in the property panel, go to the clip black and increase the value to eliminate some of the disturbances in the background. Yes, it's done. Now the background was neat and clean. See here at the edges, little bit sharp. To soften them, go to the property panel. Over here at the screen softness, change the value. Yes, it's fine. Now let's come out from the alpha mode by pressing the letter A again. Now take in another merge node, connect the arrow B to this transformation node and disconnect this corner pin 2D. And now arrow A to the key light node and corner pin 2D arrow to this merge node and the viewer node to this merge 1 node. Now see here, the footage is not perfectly aligned or inserted into the TV screen. So let's arrange the footage in perfect way so that it will place exactly inside the screen. Now see here, the edges of this footage was not clear. To avoid that, let's take the roto node. If you have any doubts in roto node, please check the video of chapter 7. For now, I am directly drawing the bezier to extract this character. Now animate this bezier shape for the entire footage. So I am fast forwarding this video till I finished rotoscoping. Yes, it's finished. Now attach this merge mask arrow to this roto node. Now let's play the video and check once. Yes, we have inserted an footage into this TV screen successfully. So this is all about the corner pin 2D tracking. Now let's move on to the next topic, planar tracker. You can use the planar tracker to track the ridged objects and the objects that deforms slightly throughout the track. The planar tracker tries to fit a plane to the object to be tracked. For instance, a wall or a flat side of an object are a good planes. But you can also get good results in tracking faces or people. And it is also very important that the plane you are tracking has some texture. Now let's open the Nuke and see how planar tracker works. Now see here in the footage we have a yellow plane board. We will attach a baby photo onto this yellow board. So to do that, we need to track this yellow plane board. Press the tab key and type a planar tracker and select from the drop down list. So if you see here, we have two nodes attached to each other. One is the planar tracker node and another one is the roto node. Now attach this roto node BG arrow to this footage and viewer node to the roto node. Now see here, the planar tracker source arrow is being attached to the roto node. That means we are going to track the roto shape. Now again connect this source arrow to this roto node. See here in the viewer panel we have both roto tools and planar tracker tools. These section tools are the tracking tools which we have already seen in the chapter 4. If you have any doubts, please watch that video. This section is the clear tracking tool and this section is the planar tracking tool. This section is the reference frame section. This section is the keyframe tools. And this drop down menu is the layer selected tools. And last one is the corner pin tool. All these options we have in the property panel also. Now we'll see each and every tool. So first take the bezier and draw the shape. Now see here in the property panel, when we are drawing the roto shape, we'll get the planar tracker properties automatically. Now track this roto shape by pressing this tracking forward button, which we have already discussed in chapter 4. Here we got the error that the current frame is not a valid frame. So let's change it here. The current frame has 2000 because our first frame is starting from 2000. Now see here, the timeline header point is on 2000. Now click on this forward tracking button. Yes, it's done. Tracking has finished. Now see here, this button is the clear all button. If you click on this, all our tracking data will be cleared. In simple words, you can say as all our tracking keys will be erased. Now see here, the rotor shape has placed again to the starting position. This button is the clear backward button, which clears the tracking data towards to the backward from the current frame. This button is the clear forward button, which clears the tracking data towards to the forward from the current frame. Now again, track this rotor shape because we have cleared all the tracking data by pressing the clear all button. So track it once again to check the rest of the tools. So it's finished. This button is the center button. If you click on this, it will take you to the center part of the tracking surface plane for the current frame. This button is the display tracking button. If you click on this, the tracking points inside the planar surface will display. This button is the display planar surface button. By clicking on this, it will display the blue frame and it will indicate the area that which we are tracking for the entire frames. And this button is the current frame. If you click on this, it will show you the current frame position for the current timeline frame. And this button is the display grid line button. Click on this to display the grid line. See here, this is the grid line box. Anyhow, mostly we will not use this grid frames in planar tracking. And this button is the reference frame box. Click on this to get the reference frame box. With this reference frame box, you can replace the footage or an image. And this button is used to set a reference frame to the current timeline frame. This section is the keyframe tools, which we already learned in chapter 4. So I am skipping this. Here you can select the layer on which you are currently working with. Now we are working with the planar tracker, so it has been selected as a planar tracker. This section is used to insert the corner pin. Here relative means between the current frame and the reference frame. Absolute means from the starting frame to the end frame. Stabilize means the corner pin 2D is used to stabilize the footage. This tracker creates another tracker with the reference of these four trackers. Baked means if you have any damage in the footage or any burns in the footage. Burn means if you have more highlights in the footage, then to get tracked at that point, we use baked. So all these options are also presented in the property panel. This tracking tab indicates all the tracking data which we have tracked. Now let's go to the original concept of planar track. So let's get started. Now I am taking this bezier and drawing a box around this yellow board. In planar tracking, make sure that your surface or a plane have a good texture. Yes, it's done. Now click on this forward tracking button to track. Now over here, click on this current plane button. See here, in the viewer panel, we got a blue color box. So now again, click on to this, go to reference frame button. You will get an yellow frame box. Now adjust this yellow box where you want to insert a baby photo. So I am adjusting over here onto this yellow board. Now check each and every frame manually whether the yellow frame box has been tracked perfectly or not. Yes, it's been tracked. But once again, play the video and check. Yes, the yellow frame has been tracked perfectly. Now it's time to insert the image. So I'm importing this baby photo to insert onto the yellow board. Now take the merge node and connect this arrow B to this roto node and arrow A to this baby photo and viewer node to this merge node. Now take the transformation node by pressing the letter T in the keyboard to arrange the image perfectly onto the board. Let's scale it down little bit and place it on this yellow board. Now let's skew it little bit so that it will align onto the board in a perfect angle. Now scale it down individually of the length and height. Yes, it's fine. So I'm zooming out. Now let's go to the planar tracker node property panel. Here at the export section, select the corner pin 2D relative and click on this create button. Now see here, the corner pin 2D has been generated. Attach this corner pin 2D arrow to this transformation node and this arrow A to this corner pin 2D. Now see here, the baby photo is slightly out of the box. Now let's place it inside the reference frame. Yes, it's done. Now let's play the video and check once. Now see here, we have placed the baby photo onto the board perfectly without any errors. So this is all about the tracking part 2, corner pin 2D and planar tracking. So we will meet in the next topic. Bye bye.